Drew Barrymore first stole our hearts at the age of 5 in the classic film E.T. She romanced Hollywood's hottest and funniest in a string of hits and took it full throttle as one of Charlie's Angels. Now this mega-successful actor and producer makes her directorial debut with a film about a girl following her dream through the rough-and-tumble world of roller derby in Whip It.
What is this? Roller derby?
Welcome to skate night at the warehouse.
I just want to tell you all that you're my new heroes.
Well, put some skates on. Be your own hero.
The last time I wore skates, they had Barbies on them.
Has anyone ever thrown up on the track before?
Yeah.
Get ready to meet your newest Girl Scout.
Hey!
Earlier this week, Drew dropped by our New York studios to chat to Rove.
Well, Drew Barrymore, it's very good to see you.
It's always nice to see you.
Now, you sound like you're a bit fluey. I'm hearing the word pneumonia and I'm worried.
Well, I'm actually okay, but we did a cross-country tour to promote Whip It, and I got pneumonia from all the traveling.
But does having pneumonia mean you're going to die?
I certainly hope not.
Oh, good, because I thought it was like the Black Plague. I thought people just couldn't get it anymore.
Well, apparently you can. But that said, I have no idea how I'm going to die, but I think a little ammonia is not going to be the thing that would take me down.
Well, look, I can imagine why, because you've worked very hard on this one. You've directed it, you've starred in it, plus you did the whole thing on roller skates.
Yes, yes. And I produced it as well, so I wore, 8,000 hats. It was great to be able to conduct the symphony, all the time.
So you really did do all your own stunts in this?
Absolutely.
No, you did not. You're too rich and famous.
No, I'm certainly not, A, and B, you can really enjoy a movie much more when you see an actor doing their own stunts. It's so much more exciting. You can't fake that kind of athleticism, so I refuse for actresses to be doubled.
Oh, yeah, I mean, there'd be so much pressure on you as a member of your cast when you're leading by example and taking these horrific bumps.
Yes.
If I'd want a pussy out, I'd bruise like a grape.
We did bruise a lot, but it does help when you're in there with them and you're not just being a sideline dictator going, oh, I know it's scary, but just go ahead and, go for it.
Yes, it did.
You could be our mascot.
So did you all train together?
Yep, absolutely. We had a big, hardcore training camp. Some girls trained for 3 months, some girls trained for 2, but we had an intensive all-cast, 6 to 7 days a week, all day long, derby training camp for 1 solid month before we started shooting.
How bad were you before training started?
Oh, I mean, I look like a little pig who put on 4 roller skates and, was skating down like a butter oil slick. I was literally like, you've never seen a more pathetic looking injured pigeon. But then one day, you skate backwards and you don't fall down, or one day you jump over a girl and you land on your skates and you keep skating and you're like, wow, I've really learned something. And you get excited to strap on your skates the next day and go at it again. So you really get better, and then you get like, I want to get out there and do more.
Well, I just hope there's skills that you can use later in life.
Well, we'll see.
The other really cool thing I love about the movie is the names of the characters in there. Your character, Smashley Simpson, among others. Where did these names come from? Is this what normal roller derby people have?
Yeah, absolutely. They're their alter ego, and they're a play on words, a play on names. You can go to whipit.net and create your own derby name.
I did just that, Ms. Barrymore.
Oh, excellent. And what is yours?
Rove McManus came out as Diamond Tasty Cha-Cha.
Well, I could read a lot into that. But I think that's fun.
Looking good, Barbie.
Are you ready for your public probe, Drew Barrymore?
I'm ready to be probed.
Let's do this thing. From Humphrey, New South Wales, what is the most embarrassing thing you've ever had to do, either on screen or in real life?
I don't know. I feel like every day I do something embarrassing. So if I can actually accomplish one day where I don't make a total fool of myself, it's a pretty good day.
Well, I've made a pretty good living out of it, so there's nothing wrong with it, let me tell you.
Yeah.
Gary from New South Wales, when you were younger, did you ever have a celebrity crush?
Oh, my God, so many. I was so in love with Andrew McCarthy.
Oh, yeah.
And Maxwell Caulfield and Corey Feldman. And
that's a good mix.
Yeah, they were all really cute.
Madeline from Queensland, if you were to be reincarnated as an animal, what would you want to be?
A dog. I love dogs so much.
Well, then I have to ask the follow-up question. If you were a dog and you could, would you?
Could what?
Oh, they lick their testicles.
Oh, yeah.
And from Alex in Victoria, what's the least appropriate moment you've ever started giggling?
I remember when a family that I was staying with took me to church and I couldn't stop laughing so hard I was snotting into my hand. The moment you're really not supposed to laugh is when you laugh the hardest. And in this church, I created the term church laugh.
Nicely done. And nicely done on the movie. It's a great one.
This film really is, of all the films I've ever done, the most of my own heart that I've put into something, so I really hope people enjoy it.
I don't think you have much to worry about with that one.
Thank you.
Except pneumonia. Just, again, please, just don't die, okay? Go see a doctor, do the church laugh, get the snot out, and get yourself better. Rest up.
Will do, and lovely to see you.
Lovely to see Barrymore. You can catch her new film, Whippets, in cinemas now. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.